On this new mini EDC episode where we don't feature any bags, just the gear in our actual pockets, we're doing an updated channel favorite, mini blackout EDC, aka everyday carry, version 2. I mean, come on, is this not the perfect slogan to end off 2020? So let's check it out. Honestly, I did this video just to show this off, the North Face Black Series Spectra Mountain Light Suit. If it wasn't clear enough though, this is a whole onesie, but designed to handle the toughest of weather, and living in Toronto, sometimes that's kind of what you need to survive. So if you ever want to feel like a sci-fi astronaut and have a few hundred dollars lying around, this is definitely a cop. But y'all already know, no amount of snow can take away my love for hats. Although you won't see it much in the video, to complete this black on black fit, we've got the cleanest blackout cap I own and love. The modern Dayfarer cap version 2. Made of high performance cotton, it's water repellent yet still breathable, and most importantly, completely blacked out with no branding to take away from the clean aesthetics. To top it all off, they use a Fidlock magnetic buckle around back as well, and anything magnetic always wins my heart. And it takes the hat from looking like a plain black cap to some next level tech wear vibes. Now the only thing good about winter is all the pockets I get to have on me. And oh yes, the mountain suit is a pockets galore, especially these two large front pockets. So starting off, as we always do when carrying my phone, the right pocket is exclusively reserved for my iPhone 12. But more importantly, wrapped around it, the black on black prints from Rhino Shield and their tough as nails solid suitcases. For starters, it's got a soft matte rubbery like booty, lightly textured edges so your fingers have something to feel up, and the creme de la creme, the honey nut Cheerios pattern inside that we tested previously to survive this. Yeah, I dropped it on real concrete in a previous video dressed up as an urban astronaut. Full video linked in the card above. Anyways, as a case though, it just works. Raised and clicky buttons, large mute rocker cutout for any size chicken fingers, and plenty of coverage for your balls, aka camera doohickeys. I do want to point out one extra feature though, the buttons are swappable. What? So if you're feeling festive on Halloween, Rhino Shield's got you. Or maybe something a little more relevant right now. A subtle way to be cheerful, but still, blackout for life, bro. Continuing with the rest of the cutouts, plenty of space around the butthole on the bottom, but if that's not how you like it, the case is still thin enough to slow charge magnetically. But where it really counts though is in the hand, as you don't want a case that gets in the way, and thanks to the mild sandpaper-like edges and fairly slim design for what it can do, it feels way better than holding that glossy fingerprint magnet glass back on the iPhone itself. Don't worry, if you don't vibe with simple, the beauty is, they've got options, like this black on black collab with artist Neil Meal. I hope I'm saying that right. Or if you're into tech wear but also love reading your horoscope, artist Kirby Rosanes, I also hope I'm saying that right, has a whole line just for you. You didn't know you needed a black on black print until now. Of course, we had to make sure it was the real deal, and rest assured, they definitely used some breed of unicorn pee as ink, because this print came out with zero scratches for my scientific key test, so you can toss it into your pocket with keys and change like the monster you are. Now, looking cool is one thing, but combine that with a thick lip around the front, and this hexagon pattern interior that isn't just there to trigger my trypophobia, it's rated to handle up to 11 foot drops, which I've tested a gazillion times in previous videos, and is why it's one of my go-to cases on the daily. But to top off the cake, you gotta have their 3D impact screen protector as well. And oh baby, that's 360 degrees of protection without having to double the size of your phone. And to prove it, we're using a very real hammer. I don't recommend you try this at home. Thankfully, they do have a lifetime warranty on their accessories. And while I'm at it, also free worldwide shipping too. Finger swiping, tapping, and whatever else you like to do with your phone still works perfectly fine. As the TikTokers would say, the 3D impact screen protector is just built different, and I dig it. Along with all their other black on black cases, because come on, this is the blackout series after all. So if you also dig the black on black vibes, you can use my discount code to save some extra moolah. Links and details are in the description down below. Moving along to the other pocket, an EDC staple, the wallet. This one from Sleek Life Design, the Veered Wallet. And all I have to say is it's nothing I've seen before, but I love that I found it. It's got this squarish shape that you don't typically see in a wallet, and combine that with an all metal frame, it gives it a total blackout Pokedex vibe. However, it's this strange asymmetrical cutout that slightly triggers me, but it's designed to allow you to easily swipe your cards downwards and then also upwards. Yeah, so with its capacity to hold up to 6 cards, this allows you to shuffle through each card without having to take them all out at once. There's no extra parts, gears, or anything that could potentially break, just a smart way of utilizing your thumb one-handed. And don't worry, they've made it so that even with a double-sided opening, no cards slide out in my scientific shake test. It doesn't end there though. Around back is a large cash strap, which there isn't much to say, other than that it works really well in holding anything relatively flat. The wide elastic band means it should also last for quite some time before it gets too stretched out, but what really takes this to the next level of wallets, and why it's such a thick boy, is this hidden slide-out drawer. It's not super deep, but it's perfect for coins, keys, and you know it, daily essentials. And for all you commenting not to carry these in your wallet, well, thankfully, all metal build, nothing's getting squished in this baby. Everything is actually hidden away and very surprisingly held in place securely too. So if you don't mind the thick boy size, the trade-off is you're getting one of the most functional wallets I've ever tested. Next up for you old school gamers, a deck of cards. This one from the most relevant Blacko brand, Black Paris. Come on. You just know this is gonna be hot damn. Similar to the Rhino Shoe cases, this has a matte finish with a glossy branded black on black print on the back. A little loud for my taste, but that two-tone black is hard to say no to. They've got custom designed court cards and overall just a very minimal aesthetic. It's actually surprisingly hard to find total Blacko cards on the market. So these come in very clutch and according to the website, is also very limited too. They feel durable in the hand, like they won't bend so easily, plus they're plastic cards, so it can deal with your nervous hand sweat much better than regular playing cards, and you can actually wash them if you have friends with really clammy hands. So for the casual family get together, you can pull these out for the most aesthetically pleasing game of Big Two you'll ever play. Plus a neat bonus, the box is also a super clean blacked out plastic case, so unlike the paper boxes from regular playing cards that slowly deteriorate, this will last just as long as the cards do themselves. Now my all time favorite find for this Blacko collection, a fidget toy that you can actually purchase and won't break the bank. Another from Sleek Life Design, this is the Ono Roller. Ono Roller? Literally two spinning bars attached together that let you do this. Yeah, it's super simple, kind of silly, but that's kind of what fidget toys are, really. Honestly, the build quality surprised the heck out of me. For only $30, it's made of all metal, literally cold to the touch. It makes it feel way more expensive than it is, but if I had to explain it, it's like a really fat motorcycle toy or something. With the curved and round edges everywhere, it's very addicting to continuously just roll this in your hand. You can also squeeze it really hard, and there's just something satisfying about it rolling round and round in your hand. You can also roll it between your hands, on the table, and it also doubles as a decent massager too. Personally, I think it looks cool enough that it can be mistaken for like a lighter or vape of some sort, but if you're familiar with the Arthur meme, this can be the perfect tool to squeeze as hard as you can and help with your anger management problem. Now while this beautiful fit is full of pockets on pockets, I wanted to highlight another simple way to add more storage to your carry. A lanyard. Any kind will do, and I'm sorry I can't find this Nike one sold anymore, but attached to it are arguably the most important when you head out, keys. And how fitting it is to feature one of the smallest Blacko key holders I've ever tested, the KeySmart Mini. But more importantly, also attached, the key tag that we all strive to be, with some extra bling from the same designer. This is the mostly okay key tag from Something Nice Supply on Etsy. Made of what feels like a semi-stiff nylon tag with embroidered block-like text on the front side, and also their monochrome rainbow pin that just embodies all the feels of this slogan. It's just thick, sturdy, and won't break the bank. Attached on the same key ring though, literally just a thick rubber strap with a bolt screwed through the end. And I love it for how simple and effective that is. The KeySmart Mini keeps up to 5 keys organized in a single place, making retrieval quick and easy, eliminating any jingle bells while you walk, and all while adding almost little to no weight to your pocket. Plus, it also creates this loop shape to attach other accessories. Given it's so small, I find that adding the key tag not only makes you super relatable, but also helps with grabbing onto something tangible in your pocket for quick and easy removal. So if you only carry a few keys and don't want to bulk up, this is the perfect solution that you'll barely notice is there. Finally, to maximize on additional storage options without having to get an actual bag, there's pouches. Really tiny pouches, like this one from Defy Bags. Their micro pouch made of X-Pack, a very durable, water resistant, and lightweight material. Combined with the waterproof AquaGuard zipper, this is the most overkill micro pouch you'll ever own, and I freaking love it. Although quite small, that's kind of the point. It's perfect to carry even smaller goodies, like these stainless steel blacked out dice that come optionally bundled with the Black Paris playing cards. It's another retro gaming option, but there's something about dice when you hold it in your hand that you just love fidgeting with as well. These being made to feel premium thanks to its all metal bodies just makes it that much more satisfying. There's not much else to say though. Back in the day, rolling some dice made for some fun times or quick cash. If you know, you know. So it never hurts to have a solid pair of dice to just whip out and start making some side bets for fun. Moving along, we've got quite a few other tiny goodies in here, like this. My first magic item that I'm showing off because it's the perfect party trick you can pull out and fool literally anyone, anywhere. This is the ignition key from magician Chris Smith. To start, you can hand out the key to examine beforehand, then you ask for a bill from anyone in the audience. Pointing at the center of the bill, you stab right through it with your key and wha-bam. Don't worry though, the key is fine because you can tear it right out, but wait. Taking a closer look at the bill, you can show them that there's actually no hole in it, handing the bill back to the spectator to feel for themselves, and you're even able to give them the key to examine again, where they discover that it's just a regular key. Moving along, one of the most unique pen designs I've come across from CWNT, probably some of my favorite designers, this is the Pen Type C. Essentially, it's a flat pen with an all-metal bill. The cap is actually a bar that runs around the tip to protect it. You simply rotate it like a garden fence door and snap it in place to go ham on some paper. Since it uses a Pilot Hi-Tech C ink cartridge, you just know it's gonna be smooth sailing from here. With the built-in clip and flat design, it's the perfect notebook pen as it can double as a bookmark, but thanks to the all-metal design, it's plenty durable and slim enough to clip into your pocket and take with you, just in case you ever get asked for an autograph or something. This next one is from Mech Army, their CPL2 mini LED light, and they weren't kidding when they called it mini. It charges through the futuristic USB-C plug and can last about 45 minutes on high, which is the mode you'll probably use it on the most, and it operates with a single power button, cycling through the three levels of brightness, plus a turbo mode in case things get too rowdy. The aluminum body makes it a durable little guy, but also very lightweight, and it also helps that it's about the size of a quarter. Oh, and it's also waterproof. What? So if you ever find you need some extra light but don't want to weigh yourself down, this can easily fit onto your keys and blend right in. Now I've read all your comments, I know you want some budget gear, so it's a Christmas miracle as I'm sprinkling some in here. This is a clipper lighter in a blacked out metal body. Easily one of my favorite lighters simply for how reliable yet affordable it is. The metal body makes it feel like some fancy Zippo, but taller, while only costing under $20. So it's one you can toss around without having to worry about scratching, denting, or even breaking, because I've definitely done that, and this little guy is still popping for me. Now straight back to money well spent though, the tool of choice in this loadout from Joe Knives, this is the Lynx Blade. I guess you can call it that. It's kind of like if James Bond had a business card, because this fella definitely looks the part and feels it too. Made of VG10 steel, basically the fancy stuff, it's got a sharpened edge along one side with a cheese grater on the other. I imagine you can get creative and use it in other ways, but it does make for a really comfortable and grippy handle too. Now at first, I thought the same thing you do right now. Why? Well, if you need a long blade, that typically comes in a bulky package. But this single piece of metal is smaller than a credit card, and only about as thick as one too. I've personally never seen anything comparable in performance to size, especially if you want to enjoy a tasty midday snack. This blade slices like butter. Plus, cleanup is super simple thanks to the large surface area. Now, the included paper sheath is tear and water resistant, so you can pop this into your wallet and have a backup blade at all times without having to take up any additional pocket space. However, if you go the micro pouch route, as you saw before, it isn't a bad choice either given how much you can carry. Plus, with the tough X-Pack material, it ensures the gear inside isn't going to be scratching up anything outside of it. It also kind of just looks very cute, but also very vicious. If that's even possible. So if you like to carry a bunch of doodads and doohickeys, I highly recommend micro pouches to keep your pockets organized. And it's also got a built-in paracord loop, making it easy to attach onto your belt or keys, but it's also just great on its own as well, perfect to just throw in one of your pockets in your very expensive onesie.
This is most likely the last video of 2020 for me, so leave a comment down below what your favorite video was from this year and what you'd like to see next year, but that's it. I rest my case.